Well, if you didn't know, now you know. Yeah, it does snow in Arizona, and I want to wish you all a happy new year. So if you do a simple Google search, you'll find that most pictures on Arizona are all about the desert. But if you head 2.5 hours north to Flagstaff, Arizona, you'll see a different picture. Bam! So here we are, going to Flagstaff, Arizona, and it is snowing. Snow all around. So stay tuned, and you'll see what happens later on today. Damn! Holy moly, bruh. Yeah, so unfortunately, as you can see, it does get kind of treacherous and icy on the road, so stay safe out there and drive with caution if you're going up to Flagstaff, because things can change in a quick second. Getting gas right now. Got the Tundra right here. And we got the Gladiator. The hardtop smart cat. So after we got gas, we started heading to the trail, and it's called Cinder Hills OHV Trail, which is around 20 to 30 minutes from Flagstaff, Arizona. And it's like a loop trail, and the thing about it, it's moderate because the gravel underneath the snow is ashy like sand, so you can easily get stuck if you're not careful. We waited on one more Jeep Cherokee, and then we aired down to about 25 PSI, and then we headed back on the trail. Find a spot to cook up some lunch. So this is Cinder Hill. Don't forget to hit the subscribe button and turn your post notifications on. So after a little short drive, we found this, I believe it's a Christmas tree or a pine tree, but it was a really big tree. We decided to set up a little spot and make some lunch, because we were all pretty hungry after the long drive from Phoenix. Billy's cooking channel.
Uh-huh. Billy?
What are we cooking here? What we got going on?
Brisket.
Brisket?
Leftover brisket from Christmas.
That's good.
From last night. Take that, Marco.
Good for the heart.
Also, if you're wondering why the pebbles are black, it's because there's volcanic cinder cones and craters surrounding the area.
It's so cold.
So after we ate the brisket, the salmon, rice, and noodles, we decided to hit up the hill, do a little hill climb. Oh, that thing's light. That thing's light.
Can I go up?
Let's go. I'm taking this angle right here. Well, that's actually probably easier. That one looks like a straight line going up there. Let's see this Forerunner right here. Is he gonna go up? Try it. Let's go, Forerunner. Here we're gonna see the Forerunner attempt to climb the hill on that middle side of the hill. So the thing with him is it looks pretty stock, and the thing is, I don't know if he aired down, so he guns it pretty hard, but I don't know if he aired down, so I think that's why he got stuck, because it's kind of soft underneath the snow.
Oh.
Oh. Muddy up there. Oh, that guy got stuck too. That pickup truck got stuck. I'm just gonna crawl up it. I'm gonna try it. I'm gonna crawl up it slowly.
Too soft.
Is it too soft?
Oh, yeah.
We'll see. Those guys are going fast though, and they're still getting stuck. I'm gonna try going slow. That way I'm just gonna fall down.
That part right here is really stuck.
Yeah, I think I'm gonna go right.
Mission failed. We'll get them next time.
See, right here is a prime example of why airing down is important. See that pickup truck? I'm pretty sure none of these people aired down, so even airing down to 25 PSI helped a lot going up the hill.
This Ford F-150, you're gonna get stuck right there.
So after seeing the Ford F-150, the Chevy truck, and the 4Runner get stuck, I decided to make an attempt on the hill. So my first attempt at a hill climb was actually at the Widowmaker last year at Sycamore Creek in Arizona. And that one seemed like it was a lot steeper than this hill, but this one was a lot higher, and the wind blowing just made it a lot, it seemed like it was a lot more intimidating. So check it out. So right here, the 4Runner got stuck earlier in the middle side of the hill. He's gonna attempt the left side of the hill, which I'm gonna attempt after him. And he actually puts more acceleration, more speed, and with his momentum, it actually got him up the hill on this side. So it gave me a lot of confidence, because seeing that 4Runner, which was pretty stock, and knowing I have an 80 series Land Cruiser with 25 PSI and on 4 low, you know, I was pretty confident I was going to climb up this hill pretty easily, and basically that's what I did. So right here, after I made it up, it was pretty windy, and I was pretty just satisfied of getting up the hill, and decided just to go back down, you know, and relax. It was really windy up there and cold. The wind gust was pretty strong that day, so. But yeah, it was pretty cool getting up that hill. I mean, on video, it doesn't look that steep, but in real life, you're actually there. It looks really, really high when you're driving up that thing, so. Just keep that in mind if you end up checking this. Cinder Hills out. So on the way back down, I managed to get a Birador 90. Follow him on Instagram. His name's Leo, and he's got the Toyota Tundra. I managed to get him coming up the hill on the way back down. So I'm just gonna time lapse this part, come back down, and we'll see what happens next. After I got down, Billis 86 with the Jeep Gladiator went up. And also, the Jeep Cherokee that was with us ended up getting stuck. And I believe he didn't air down at all. He was running like 35 maybe PSI. And yeah, they had to use the max tracks to get him out. And that's why it's important to air down. It may seem like it won't help at all, but it actually improves your tire foothold on the ground, so you actually have your tires able to grip on more surface area than if you didn't air down at all. So yeah, here's another reason why to air down. Otherwise, you're probably gonna get stuck. Well, there you have it, my cruisers. I hope you enjoyed this video with AZ Pinoy Overland. I'll link their Instagram in the description. And again, thank you for watching. Like and comment. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button as we're coming back for more adventures in 2022. Hope you all have a blessed and safe year. And we're coming back for more. All right, the AZcruiser out. Let's keep cruising.